Hello everyone, this is Navanita. Now we are going to discuss the topic from gravitation. So here the topic, deduction of the universal law of gravitation. So Newton know that the motion of moon around the earth is approximately uniform circular motion. Yes. Here the motion of the moon around the earth is approximately uniform circular motion. We know what is mean by uniform circular motion. So that motion of a body with constant speed around a circular path is called uniform circular motion, right? So any object with constant speed when it is rotate in a circular path, so that motion is known as uniform circular motion. So here the motion of moon around the earth is approximately uniform circular motion. So certain net force, which we call centripetal force, yes, is required to maintain the uniform circular motion. So we know centripetal force means the net force required to keep the body in circular motion. So here the centripetal force keeps the body in circular motion. Yes, the net force required to keep the body in circular motion. So here it is required to maintain the uniform circular motion. So here he introduced the idea of force of attraction. Yes, Newton introduced the idea of force of attraction between the moon and the earth. Yes, he proposed that earth attracts moon. Okay, he proposed that earth attracts moon and termed it as gravitational force. So this gravitational force acts as a centripetal force. Yes, here the gravitational force acts as a centripetal force. Yes, so here and makes the moon revolve around the earth in uniform circular motion. So Newton know that the following data, the distance of the moon, okay, the distance of the moon from center of the earth is 384,400 kilometers, which equals to 3.844 into 10 to the power of 10 centimeters. And the moon takes 27.3 days or 2.35 into 10 to the power of 6 seconds for a complete revolution around the earth. Okay, now here you can calculate the speed of the moon using the equation v equals to 2 pi r by t. So thus the acceleration of the moon towards the center of the earth, okay, here the acceleration of the moon towards the center of the earth is am, so acceleration of the moon, which is equals to v squared by r. We can also write equals to 4 pi square r by t square. So when we substituting the values of r and t in this above equation, so we get acceleration of the moon equals to 0.27 centimeter per second square. So here the acceleration of the moon equals to 0.27 centimeter per second square. So here Galileo found that the acceleration of bodies acquired near the surface of the earth. So Galileo found that the acceleration of bodies acquired near the surface of the earth is equal to 981 centimeter per second square. So thus here the acceleration of an apple approximately is equal to 981 centimeter per second square. Yes, he compared both the acceleration of an apple, that is AE, to the acceleration of the moon, AM. Okay, now he is comparing both accelerations of apple and moon. So apple is a AE and acceleration of moon is AM. So we get here AE by AM. So here Galileo found that acceleration of the body is acquired near the surface of the earth, which is equals to 981 centimeter per second square. So here the acceleration of the apple equals to 981. And we got acceleration of the moon 0.27 centimeter per second square. So when we divide these two, so we'll get here 3640. Okay. So take this as equation 1 here. Now, here Newton know that the radius of earth. Okay. So the radius of earth and the distance of the moon from the center of the earth. So here the radius of the earth and the distance of the moon from the center of the earth are 6371 kilometer and 384,400 kilometers respectively. So here the radius of the moon is 384,400 kilometers and the radius of the earth is 6371. Yes, when we divide this, we'll get 60.3. Yes, so here, when we square this terms, so we'll get 3640. So the equation 1 and equation 2 are equal here. Right? So from this equation 1 and 2, it is clear that AE by AM, that means acceleration of the apple, by acceleration of the moon equals to radius of the moon by radius of the earth. So we get here acceleration is proportional to 1 by r square. And the force of attraction, that means F is proportional to 1 by r square. Yes, now here it becomes clear that the force of gravity decreases with increase in distance of the object from the center of the earth. Right? So here the force of gravity. Okay? The force of the gravity decreases with increase in distance of the object from the center of the earth. Yes? From the center of the earth here to this earth and object, the force of gravity decreases when the distance between the object and center of the earth is increases. Yes, so when the distance is decreases, then the force of gravity is increases. Right, so according to Newton's third law, the force on the apple, we know Newton's third law, action is equals to reaction, right? So here force on the apple by the earth is equals to the force on the earth by the apple, right? Here the force on the apple by the earth is equals to the force on the earth by the apple. Here action and reaction forces are takes place. So we get the force on an object by the earth. Yes, so we get the force on an object by the earth by using the second law of motion and equation 3. So from Newton's second law of motion, we can write F equals to ma, force equals to mass into acceleration. And from equation 3, we can write here acceleration is inversely proportional to radius. Right? So A is proportional to 1 by r square. So when we remove this proportionality, we'll get proportionality constant. So we can write A equals to k by r square. So here k is a proportionality constant. So we get here F equals to km by r square. Right? Yes. So here, therefore, the force on the apple, okay, The force on the apple by the earth equals to Km by R square. Okay? Here M is a mass of apple and R is a radius of the earth. Here the force on the apple by the earth, that equals to Km by R square. Here K is a proportionality constant and M is a mass of an apple and R is a radius of the earth. Right? Now, here force on the earth by the apple equals to K dash, here capital M by R square. Yes? Here again K is a proportionality constant. M is a mass of the earth. Okay? Here M is a mass of the earth. Here, the above forces are equal in magnitude only when the following condition is satisfied. Okay, when K equals to Gm, that is capital G and capital M. Here G is a gravitational constant and M is a mass of the earth. And K dash equals to capital G small m. Here again capital G is a gravitational constant and M is a mass of an apple. Right? So here the above forces are equal in magnitude only when these conditions are satisfied. So take this as equation 7 here. So from equations 5 and 7, we have force on apple. Okay? Force on apple by the earth. That is F equals to Gmm by R square. Right? Here G is the gravitational constant and capital M is a mass of the earth and small m is a mass of an apple, R is a radius of the earth. So we conclude that gravitational force between the mass, is directly proportional to the product of their masses. Yes, the gravitational force between the mass is directly proportional to the product of their masses.